artist of the month, Justin Bieber there with Dan and Shay, 10,000 Hours, the last leg of Conversation Why, World Obesity Day special with Dr. Muffy, Dr. Mufazzal Lagrawala. Don't go anywhere.
This is Good Morning Mumbai with Rishi K.
What's the policy change that you'd like to see happen in this particular country? I mean, every fifth person is obese. It's growing like an epidemic. Policy-wise, what can we do to fight obesity?
I think the government needs to recognize that obesity is a disease. I know it's a tricky situation for them, given India has got malnourishes as a problem as well. But the problem is that a lot of the obese people are also malnourished. They're vitamin D deficient, they're iron deficient, they're B12 deficient, because half of us are vegetarians. Mm. So the moment we recognize it as a disease, solutions will come up. Schools need to ban all forms of sugar, because it's just not healthy for kids to get used to. Every food label should carry the amount of hidden sugar. It's not the amount of sugar they talk about, but the hidden sugar that is contained in the food products. You should tax probably the sugar drinks much more, so that people try and avoid it. They'll still have it, but try and avoid it. It's like smoking. Mm. I think sugar is the next smoking, is what I would tag. If you want to prevent obesity, prevent sugar. Any form of processed sugar. Natural sugar is out there. Enough of it in our fruits, in our vegetables, in the milk that we have. You don't really need to go and subject yourself to processed sugar at all.
Satish Nair on Twitter. What are the short-term and long-term side effects and complications?
So the short-term side effects, Satish, it's a stomach reductive surgery. You will get a little bit of nausea. That will happen even with weight loss medications. You will, if you overeat, you will tend to throw up. That's probably the best side effect. Complications, if the, like I said, the surgery done well, there aren't too many long-term issues. If you take your multivitamins and nutrition, then not a problem at all.
Pooja Punjabi, I think the biggest challenge is bringing out the change in the lifestyle of a person dealing with obesity. It's more psychological than physical in a lot of cases. And I have to say this about the Digestive Health Institute, because I've gone and visited Dr. Muffy there. Everybody's got a smile on their face, and you really counsel them, isn't it? It's more mental than physical.
That's where it all starts with. The obesity journey is a chronic disease, so it's a lifelong journey. So if I were to just treat you at one shot, it wouldn't work at all. I would say that, Pooja, you're quite correct. It is not only a physiological thing, but it is a problem wherein it's like the spring. Every time you put pressure on the spring, it comes down. As long as the pressure maintains, it will stay there. But the only thing is, when you release that pressure, it just goes back and you start putting that weight on. You ask anyone who's been obese, not overweight, but obese, and tried to lose that weight and successfully maintain that weight loss, 0.01% of people manage to do that. Successfully.
Which actually answers Vishal Gondal's question. Hey Vishal, what's up? Hello Doc Muffy, is bariatric surgery a quick fix or a last option for people? What is the percentage of people who gain their weight back after surgery? So that bit about quick fix or last option.
So Vishal, the only medically supervised sustained weight loss option for morbidly obese people is bariatric surgery. It's definitely not a shortcut. It's definitely not a quick fix. What are the chances of you regaining weight? It depends on the type of surgery you've had, and it depends on the lifestyle you follow after that. But the chances are that you'll never get back to where you were or where you started off from.
Azmeen, can you please ask Doc if skin and hair gets affected because of lesser nutrient consumption, which is caused by a curb in the food intake, or is this a myth? And then, when a patient comes to you, do you work on lowering the patient's weight by healthier food intake and exercise? If that lowers the weight, do you still advise surgery?
So I'll take the second question first. If someone loses weight and maintains that weight loss, you don't need surgery. I mean, remember I said this is for all those people who've failed all other options at trying to lose weight and trying to get a control of their obesity. Now, the first question, I mean, whenever you go on any kind of diet, be it surgical or medical, you are bound to affect your hair, because that's where the body cuts down nutrition from. And that's why most nutritionists or most bariatric surgeon and their nutritional team will probably advise you to take enough of zinc, enough of iron, and enough of proteins to make sure that, albeit there'll be a little bit of hair loss, but it will not be as significant as you might think it would be.
How do you know you're obese? Sometimes weight may be there and you might not be obese. And generally, what weight is obese? That's Shreya Shah. He actually answered that right at the top, but briefly.
Yeah, the body mass index, Shreya. So it's your weight in kgs divided by height in meters square. If your BMI is anything above 27.5 or your waist is anything above 90 centimeters as a female, you're already in the morbidly obese category. If your BMI is above 37.5, then you're in the danger zone. You're grade 3 obesity or morbid obesity.
Is bariatric surgery covered under insurance? Is my question to you now.
Yeah, that's a great question. You know, IRDA just kind of covered insurance, but still the knowledge base around bariatric surgery being covered easily with is not there. What I would recommend is that since the IRD has just passed it, for all of you guys looking at getting insurance cover for your bariatric surgery, please go out, catch hold of your agent and tell him to become abreast and aware of the latest guidelines from the IRDA from India.
I'm going to ask him to stay on for just a couple of minutes more. Because I got to take some messages, and he's going to tell us about the Digestive Health Institute and what it was formed, and his parting thoughts on the World Obesity Day special. By yourself.